Hi students, welcome back to this session. In this session, we shall discuss about the quadratic equation, which is coming from 10th class mathematics, chapter 4. What is quadratic equation? In this session, we shall discuss about quadratic equation, what is quadratic equation, and whether the equation is quadratic equation or not, we can verify that. After that, we shall discuss about how to solve the quadratic equation by using factorization method. In this session, we shall discuss all these things. Let us know what is quadratic equation. Quadratic equation is nothing but which is in the form of x square plus bx plus c is equal to 0 when x is a variable. When you take x as a variable, at the time we can say right in the form of the quadratic equation, which is in the form of x square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. When a, b, c are a real number and a is not equal to 0. If a is 0, then it will be 0. So the similarly, if the bx is equal to 0 when the px is a polynomial and its degree, highest degree is 2, then we call it as quadratic equation. In this way, we can write like this: a, b, c are real number and would see a is not equal to 0. We can take some example like this: 2x square plus 3x plus 6 is equal to 0. It is the highest degree. This is a polynomial. This is px. When px is equal to 0 and when the degree of the px will be 2. When the degree is 2, then you call the equation is known as quadratic equation. The equation when the polynomial, the quadratic polynomial and when the quadratic polynomial is equal to 0, then we call as the quadratic equation. Then similarly, here we see the degree is, highest degree is 2. Highest degree is 1, this is 2, and this is 0 degree. So here highest degree is 2. So it is the px, the polynomial, whose degree is 2. And when px is equal to 0, at that time we call this equation, is known as quadratic equation. In this way, we can write like this: 3x plus 2x square plus 6 is equal to 0. It is also quadratic equation. 6 plus 3x plus 2x square, it is also quadratic equation. But the standard form of a quadratic equation, when we call the standard form of the quadratic equation, if the polynomial px is in a descending order of their degree, then we call it as standard form of quadratic equation. So in this way, the descending order of their degree of the polynomial, we can write in this way: 2x square plus 3x, then it is the 2 degree 2, then degree 1, then 0 degree. It is descending order. If we write the polynomial in the descending order, then this equation is known as standard form of quadratic equation. So we can check whether the equation is quadratic or not. Let us take some example whether the equation is quadratic or not. Then x minus 2 whole square of x minus 2 plus 1 is equal to 2x minus 3. We have to check this equation is quadratic equation or not. Verify it. X minus 2 whole square of x minus 2, that is x square minus 4x plus 4 plus 1, that is equal to 2x minus 3. A square plus 2 into a into b, 2 into 2 into 4, that is called 4x, plus b square, that 2 square, that is called 4. 2 square means 4, plus 1, then that is equal to 2x minus 3. Here we can write like this: x square minus 4x minus 2x plus 4 plus 1, that is still 5, minus 3, it comes to the which left side, that is plus 3, that is equal to here on the right hand side is 0. You can write like this, x square minus 6x plus 8 is equal to 0. So in this, by the solving this equation, we get this type of equation, which is in the form of ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, and abc, a means 1, a, b, and c are real number. 1, 6, and 8, a, b, c are real number, and a is not equal to 0. And a is not equal to 0. So it is a quadratic equation. So here we get the equation, the quadratic equation. Similarly, take another example. And second example, x into x plus 1 plus 8 is equal to x plus 2 into x minus 2. X into x plus 1 plus 8 is equal to x plus 2 into x minus 2. Here we can verify this equation. Then we multiply this at the left hand side. Then x into x, that is x square, plus x into 1, that is x, plus 8, is equal to. Then right hand side, we can multiply the right hand side, x into x, that is x square. Here it is a identity, which form the a plus b into a minus b. We can write directly x square minus 4. A square minus b square. This is a, this is b. A plus b into a minus b. That is a square minus b means 2 square. 2 square, that is 4. So here we can write like this, x square minus x square plus x plus 8 plus 4 minus 4. It comes to the right side, that is plus 4 is equal to 0. So x square minus x square is 0. X plus 8 plus 4, that is equal to 12, that is equal to 0. Here it is not in the form of ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Here, ax square, that is a is equal to not is equal to 0, or a is equal to here 0. That means 0 into x square plus x plus 12, that means x plus 12, 0. So it is not in the form of a quadratic equation, so it is not coming under the fold of quadratic equation. So we verify that it is, though it is not in the form of x square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, so it is not a quadratic equation. So we can solve like this. We can verify this way, in this way. So now all this, in any type of this type of question, will ask you, now you can solve in this way. Similarly, we can solve the quadratic equation by using factorization method. Factorization method, which we earlier classes we already which know that what is factorization method. To solve the factorization method by using factorization method to solve the quadratic equation. So here an example, I would take this example, 2x square minus 5x plus 3 is equal to 0. This is a quadratic equation because it is here a, b, c are not are real number and a is not is equal to 0. So it is a quadratic equation. Now we can solve this equation by using factorization method. By solving the equation, we should find out this is the polynomial. This is the quadratic polynomial. When the quadratic polynomial is equal to 0. That means if the value of x, we can take the value of x, any real number, if the sum of this value is called 0, then we call that the polynomial, the 0 of the polynomial. That x, the value of x is known as 0 of the polynomial. So 0 of the polynomial also the root of the equation, equal to the root of the equation. So here we can take ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0.
Here, when we find any which substitute of which real number by substituting the real number against the x, and we find the sum of this value is called zero, then we call the this value, the value of x, is known as zero of this polynomial. Here also, when we get the value of x, something, value of x, then we can also call the root of the polynomial, the root of the equation. This is the root of the equation. When we put the value of x and get the result zero, then we can call the root of the equation. So here, how can we find this? We have to multiply the coefficient of x square, that is 2 into 3. Then 2 into 3, that is equal to 6. We can take it as alpha and it also beta. Alpha, here also beta. Then alpha into beta, that is equal to 6. So 6 is the value, and we can take the multiple of a 6, that is 2 into 3. 6 into 1, then here, in which of the following, we can take, instead of 5, we get the result, when we take in between 2 into 3 and 6 into 1, which value, when we add this to multiple, we get the 5. Similarly, we can write in this way, 2x square minus 2 plus 3, into x plus 3 plus 3 is equal to 0. Here 2x square minus 2x minus 3x plus 3 is equal to 0. Here we can take two pair of this statement and take common in between this. So here common is 2x common, then x minus 1. Here also minus sign, common is 3. So the x minus 1, that is equal to 0. Here also, what we get? This is the x minus 1. This is also x minus 1. In between this, the minus sign is there. So we can use common x minus 1. We can take common x minus 1. What will be the another form? The 2x minus 3. That is equal to 0. When we take the x minus 1 as common, then the rest part will be 2x minus 3. 2x minus 3. That is called 0. Here, x minus 1 is called 0. And 2x minus 3 is equal to 0. We can write like this. Here, if x minus 1 is equal to 0, x is equal to, it implies that x is equal to plus 1. When 2x minus 3 is equal to 0, it implies that 2x is equal to plus 3 and x is equal to 3 by 2. In this way, we can get the 2 root, that is x is equal to 1 or 3 by 2. This is the value of x, because though it is the quadratic equation, the root of the equation will be 2. So in this way, we can solve the quadratic equation by using factorization method. Take another example also. Find 3x square minus 2 root 6x plus 2 is equal to 0. Here we can find the value of root of the equation by using factorization method. So factorization method means splitting method. This is the splitting method. We can split the middle form, the 2 form. That is, when we multiply the coefficient of x square into the 2, that is 2 into 3, that is 6, 2 into 3, alpha into beta, that is equal to 6, then the multiple of 6 is equal to 2 into 3, 6 into 1. Here, which also we can write like this, root 6 into root 6, that is equal to 6. 2 into 3, 2, 3 is 6, 6, 1 is 6, root 6 into root 6, that is also 6. So here, in this multiple, we can take which is 2 form. That is, by addition of these two multiple, we get the middle form. So we can split this middle form in this form. So you can write like this, 3x square minus root 6 x minus root 6 x plus 2 is equal to 0.
Here we split the middle term in this way, minus root 6 x minus root 6 x, that is called minus 2 root 6 x, and minus root 6 into minus root 6, that is called plus 6. So here we can take which common, emit two pairs. Here what will be the common? Here also we see that root 3 into root 2, that is equal to root 6. Root 3 into root 2, that is called root 6. Here also root 3 means, root 3 into root 3. Here we can write like this, root 3 into root 3. When we take common, we find in this way. 3 means root 3 into root 3. Root 6 means root 3 into root 2. So in this way, we can take common, which is root 3. Here, can write like this, root 3 into root 3, x square minus root 2 into root 3, x minus, which is similarly, in this way, we can write like this, root 2 into root 3, x plus 2 is equal to 0. We do not like which in your answer paper, but we would see, when we take common, we think like this. So, what will be common? This is root 3, this is root 3. This is x square, this is x. So, common will be root 3 x. If root 3x will come on, then what will the rest part? That is the root 3x minus root 2. Root 3 by root 3, that is equal to 1. Now x cancel, then root 2. Here minus sign, here root 2, here 2. 2 means root 2 into root 2. So we can take common root 2. So root 2 common, then root 3 x plus root 2, here which root 2 is common, so another which root 2 you can write, that is equal to 0. So what will the next common? This is root 3 x minus root 2, this is also root 3 x plus minus 2, sorry, this is minus. The minus divided by plus, that is equal to minus. Then here, minus root 3x minus root 2, root 3x minus root 2, common is root 3x minus 2, root 2. Then the rest will be root 3x minus root 2, that is equal to 0. So here we will get the root of the equation. Here root 3x minus root 2 is equal to 0, and root 3x minus root 2 minus root 2, that is called also 0. Same. Then root 3x minus root 2 is called 0. It implies that root 3x is equal to plus root 2. It implies that root 3x is called plus root 2, or x is equal to root 2 by root 3. So it is the value of x. So here also value of x is called also same. So this is all about how to solve the quadratic equation by using factorization method. Next session we'll discuss about another method, how to solve this quadratic equation. Thank you.